Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Activities for People Living at Home with Dementia. We are proud to offer this series with funding from the Area Agency on Aging and the United Way of Tarrant County. These programs are recorded and are made available for viewing through a YouTube channel for future use. I am your host for today's activities. I am tickled to bring to you Emily Corbin with Moving to Heal. And Emily has a new camera today and a little bit different view. So we're going to get more out of this today than we ever have before. Emily, take over.
What a sweet intro. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right. I love that you're tickled. Let's get started here. Hopefully the new camera didn't create any other obstacles. So now you'll start to hear the sound of that warm-up music that may be familiar to you now. Let's just check in and make sure that you can hear the music very softly at this point and also the sound of my voice.
Can hear your voice, but can't hear the music.
Yeah.
Great. I'm so glad I asked you now instead of three songs in, right? all right, here we go. What about now?
Yes.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. All right, so just want to remind you to get comfy on the edge of your seat.
Shoes off.
Yeah. Let's take our shoes off. So I don't know if you can see it, but today I have put a little faux animal pelt on the floor underneath my feet. And, you know, I did that because it enhances the sensory experience of my practice, right? So there's more sensation coming in through the bottoms of my feet. And when I notice that, when we notice things like that in our bodies, we connect to the sensory intelligence that is so good for us and so healing. So I don't know, give it a shot next time, but definitely feel your feet on the floor and get nice and tall through your spine. Feel your feet really connected to the chair underneath you. And just start to notice what you sense in your body right now. Let's close our eyes. You can take a hand to your heart and a hand to your belly and begin to notice what you sense with your hands. And then notice inside the body and on the skin what you sense where the hand makes contact. You can start to notice your breath moving in and out. Just soft, relaxing breath right now, and soften your shoulders. And then notice the direction, if there's a tilt at all in your pelvis, right? So many of us tend to tilt our pelvis forward towards the floor, and then many of us will round in the back and sort of hold the spine onto itself, and then maybe noticing both directions and coming back up into a tall spine so that the abdominal muscles are engaged and supporting the weight of your ribs and your shoulders and your head. Good. So check in with your body. Notice when you take a full in and out breath, what is your lung volume here? On a scale of 1 to 10, 1 is none at all, and 10 is the most. Where do you notice that your lung volume is right now? So I might say, I notice I'm a 6. So give yourself a pause to notice your lung volume. We'll come back to that at the end of our practice. Good. So hearing the music speed up is kind of our cue that we're going to open our eyes. Release your hands down away from your body and notice you feel a different sensation now in your fingers, right? And also the cool of your skin, where your hand was, or your belly, where your hand was. Good. And then a gentle sway of your spine with your palms down, right? And so notice that you can tilt one way and that way, and you'll look like a windshield wiper a little bit. But then notice what happens if you get a little more movement in the spine, so that you've got the spine kind of curving multiple ways at once. And we're doing this along that vertical plane, and so the spine is moving left and right. Yes, good. Soften your jaw, soften your shoulders. Push your feet into the ground more for stability. Good. So it's just a sweet sway, right? How you might sit and listen to music. Nice. Good. And then come back to the center. Get nice and tall in your spine again. And we're going to take that same sway, but I'll go forward and back now. So I'm turning sideways so you can see that the spine is moving differently, right? And I have to push my feet more into the floor in order to keep from falling over. And I also have to engage the muscles of the belly in order to keep from falling over. And so it can be nice and small. You're just waking up all of the muscles around the spine. Nice. And then come back up to seated nice and tall again. I'm gonna give us a little more volume in our music. And
welcome Nancy and Jackie while you're doing that.
Yes.
Welcome Nancy and Jackie.
Welcome. Great. So connecting again with the feet. We'll take our palms up. Elbows are by the side of the body, elbows bent. And your forearms almost like you're carrying a stack of books, right? So connecting to the feet with the arms in that position. Lifting one foot and then the other. Lift and press. So we lift the foot, we lift the palm. Lift and press. Lift and press. Now you can make it big or small, right? We can make it fast or slow. Right? So your body connects to this music maybe differently than mine. So I invite you to check out your body's way of connecting to the music. What's your rhythm here? Of the hands, take the hands back to the thighs and just touch, little friction. And now rumble with the feet. So it's gonna sound like a little earthquake, right? Fast or slow, could just be solid stomps, yeah? It could be a fast rumble. Your body is so still from the feet up, and you're rumbling with your feet. And come to stillness with your hands and your feet. Soften your shoulders. Good. Close your eyes and sense your feet. That's it. Nothing but noticing your feet. Nice. And now with a shift in music, inhaling, taking arms up overhead. They're about a 45 degree angle away from my body and then reaching the same way down. So we're inhaling, we take the arms up. And exhaling, we take the arms down. So now I'm going to take the arms straight out and straight down, right out in front, parallel to each other. And when you reach your arms way up over your head, when you get to that final reach way up here, can you start to shift and sense a little opening in the side of your body? Yeah, maybe reaching one arm a little higher and then the other. Good. Stay here with me. Almost like if you reach up, you could grab this magical rope, right? Reach, reach. Good. Reach, reach. And then start to pull the rope down in front of you. So I'm really opening the palm and squeezing my fingers onto this rope. Good. And now it's right in front of my belly. Good. So open palm and then closing the palm. Good. Can we bring that open palm squeeze motion, right? Just looks like jazz hand finger flick. Yeah. Same thing each side. And I'm alternating lifting one ball of the foot and then the other. Nice. So remember, there's no right or wrong way to show up to this work. As long as you show up. Nice. Four. And stay in the center. Good. Lifting one elbow and bringing it down. Yeah? Lift down. Lift down. I'm going to lift the same foot. This is our puppet show here. I'm going to look up at the elbow that I'm lifting. When I place my foot down, I'm really noticing that connection between the foot and the floor. Stay connected to your breath. Look as you lift. Look as you lift. Good. Keep going. Last one, bring it back to the center, bringing the palms back in towards the ceiling and elbows in towards the rib cage, reaching side to side sway with the palms up. Now you can move your spine more, or you can stay closer here to this center upright position. It's your body's dance. Good. And then we bring the arms out a little further away from the body and a little higher up, like in the heart space. Beautiful. And the elbows just want to feel free here. They want to dance a little more. So allow them. Good. And what happens if we draw that swaying up overhead? Look up at your hands. Soften your shoulders away from your ears. Nice. So soften your joints and allow the reaching to come from this side of your body. Yes, good. And then start to sway back down. Now the palms are facing out. Good. Good. So reaching over, I'm taking my arms parallel, fingertips reaching out. So I'm going to do that a few times on one side just to let you guys get that. Nice. And then moving to the other side. Reaching, reaching. Last one like this. Now, instead of fingertips straight out and palms flat, we're going to take that claw hand. Can you guys practice your claw? Ha, right? Ha. It's intense. All right. So taking that claw hand, reaching the same way, but with your claw hand, really engage the joints of the fingers. Lifting one foot, just as we did in all of those other ways, we're lifting a foot, placing it down. Lifting a foot, placing it down. Yeah. Nice. Claw. 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 Claw towards the screen. Claw. Yeah. Yes. Claw. Claw up. What about out to the side? And up again. Up again. And out to the side. Out to the side. Beautiful. Let go of the claw and come to creepy crawler fingers. Nice. So lifting one foot and then the other, it's just a marching motion. Nice. And then can we take our palms back down? Yeah? Hear that? Yeah, let's make that sound. I'm not a drummer, but I can try. Right on. Taking elbow strike. Yeah, so it's one palm flat, one fist in that palm. And notice, it gives your elbow this sense of like, ha, yeah? So it's a very strong, ha, yes, good. So now, what are we gonna strike, right? Maybe we're striking a target, right? It's a goal. What's on your goal list? What's on your target? And then, can you bring everything in you to meeting that goal? Maybe it lines up with the music, I don't know. So there's this fluid in the middle, ha, and ha. Can you make a ha sound with me? Nice, ha, ha, last. One is now, ha, other side. So taking that palm and opposite fist, good. The fingers are pointing in towards your body. Yeah, ha, you got it, ha. Any way you do it. So is your goal the same on this side? I don't know. Ha, whew. Maybe it's the same goal, but you approach it differently. Good. What if you struck a little higher? Good. You feel the squeeze release in that moment where you pause, right? There's this pause, release. Pause, release. Good. So everything we do is a squeeze release in a varying degree, right? So now tapping the foot, you're gonna hear this front side, I don't know, that's the rhythm. Maybe it's front side. So front side. Front side, right? Front, side, and center. Other foot. And center. Front, side. It sounds simple, but if you think too much, it gets in the way. Front. Now, can we just take front side a little faster? Any foot. Now notice, if the elbows want to dance, the core stabilizes you. Good. Ready to switch? Let's switch. So maybe you remember last week we added, there was this little crunch. Remember that squeeze release? What if we slowed it down so we could highlight the squeeze and the release? Squeeze, release, squeeze. What if you really release your fingertips, right? Yes, it's a flick with the fingers. They hide behind the thumb and then they flick. Last one like this. Yes, other side. Can we add our little crunch and our flick? Feeling that squeeze, release. Squeeze, release. Good. And now, touching flies. So right now it's this rhythmic fly catching, right? Grabbing, instead of this squeeze, release, it's release, squeeze, yeah? So flies are not quite this predictable, are they? Unfortunately not. So we might have to get unpredictable too. Okay, where are they gonna go? Where are they? I don't know. You gotta find them. Agility training. That's your squeeze release. Good. Bringing it back to center. Amazing fly catching. You're all hired. Nice. Bringing palms to center. So you'll lift through your spine and then put your weight a little further back, angling back. So I'll sit sideways so you can see the belly muscles are engaged to help support this angle. If it's comfortable, you can also have a pillow back there. It's a lift and tap, lift. If you want to kick, you can kick, but it could be as simple as lifting up. Good. Nice. So let's come back to a simpler movement with the feet. Hands at the palms, at the prayer position, and alternating one foot, ball of the foot lift, and then the other. Bam, 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 bam. So if you listen to this music, bam, bam. Very subtle. Nice. Now, we've got a little something different going on in the music, so let's alternate a little faster. Good. What about heels? Squeezing juice. So taking the feet a little further apart now and lifting one heel and squeezing juice out of that orange underneath your heel on each side. I'm going to take my palms to the ends of my thighs here, right near the knee. And I'm going to press down on my thigh while I'm pressing the same heel down. Squeeze. Squeeze, squeeze. Good. The reason you hear me huffing and puffing is that I'm aligning my exhale with that energetic output. Yeah. Good. Three, two, one. Let's come back to center. Inhale, bring your palms up. Wiggle. Shimmy. Good. Shimmy in your shoulders. What if you just shimmy your wrist? What does that look like? Okay. What about shimmying the head only? A little bobblehead. Yeah. Nice. And what if you shimmied only your ribs? It's hard. It's really hard. Now, can you shimmy your hips while you're seated? Forget about the video. Okay, what about your elbows? How do you shimmy elbows? I don't know, right? How does that go? And what about knees or thighs? What about lifting heels and just feeling the toes move through the space? Good. And then bringing your feet back to the floor again. Nice. So as we inhale, bring our palms up overhead. We're going to fold the right arm. Yeah. So your left arm is waving. Hey, how's it going? And then take that left palm to the outer edge of your right elbow. Good. So just getting kind of comfortable here for a moment, letting your shoulders relax. They sometimes want to creep up into the ears. I'm going to relax the shoulders way down. Good. And then get tall through your spine. With your next inhale, maybe just imagine getting taller, and your next exhale, you just start to reach that right elbow up even further. And maybe you start to arch and stretch the right side of the body. Yes. So stay really rooted in both your feet. Good. And notice your belly is holding you nice and steady here so that the stretch can come from the back of your right arm and the right side of the body, instead of from just contracting somewhere else. Good. Softening back towards the center and bringing that right arm in front of your chest now. The left arm comes underneath. Good. And then again, the shoulders want to come up into the ears, and can you just soften the shoulders away from the ears? And then when you're ready to exhale, you're ready to dive in, you're just going to cross it over. Yeah, and let the right shoulder just really relax. Keep the arms fairly straight without locking the elbow. And just allow for as much tension and opening there as you like. So allow yourself to inhale and sort of soften back to the center place, and exhale. That's when you decide maybe you're going to take it a little deeper. So a couple of full breaths there, softening your shoulders down each time. Good. Sense the opening in the back of your right arm and shoulder. Next exhale, just soften everything back down, maybe a little shaking out of your hand. It's a shimmy. Nice. And then let that go. We'll inhale, bring our palms up overhead again. And this time, the elbow of the left arm folds. And you can maybe touch the back of your head, or whatever you touch is great. Then that right arm, hand comes to the elbow. Stabilize in your seat. right? I got casual and started just kind of kicking my leg back, but I got to keep those feet flat on the floor and reach up, soften the shoulders away. Then you can look for the space. When you know you're stable in your base, then you can look for mobility in the upper body. Soften your gaze and allow yourself to return to the center just a little bit when you inhale, so that with the next exhale, you can take advantage of all of that space. Soften your jaw. Okay, if you're not sure if your jaw is soft or not, open your mouth nice and wide. Remember the flies? We caught all of them, so they're not going to fly in. All right. Ready? You can soften back towards the center and begin to release the arms away. The left arm crosses in front, and the arm stays relatively straight without locking the elbow. Again, remind your shoulders they don't need to protect you. You're nice and safe. And then use your next exhale to draw the arm a little deeper across the body. So every inhale, softening back towards the center. Every exhale, keep the fingers on your left hand active or awake, right? Nice. Couple more like this. And then softening your arms back to the center again. We're going to isolate the shoulders for a moment. So just one shoulder. Lift. And roll back. So it's almost like there's this kind of sweeping forward. Right? And it starts small. It starts like a shrug of the shoulder. I want you guys to see that this is the same as this. It's just that I haven't put my whole body into it. This is just the beginning. And this is somewhere down the road. Yeah? So letting the movement of the shoulder joint guide, so that you don't overextend what is a very mobile joint. Yeah? Nice. And then if you wanted to take it with the music, you could go a little bit fast and a little bit slow. So that would look like fast, 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 slow, slow, yes, fast, 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 slow, slow. Good, other side, let's go slow. So start small, start with just the shrug of the shoulder, yeah? It goes up as you inhale. Pretty soon you'll be aligning all of your breath with your movements. You won't even notice. Nice, now we can start to let it dance, let it get a little bigger. Nice. Now, what if we play with fast and slow? So, fast. Good. Slow. So it's four, fast. Too slow. Too slow, yeah. Four, fast. Nice. Come back to center. Come back to just touch. touch anywhere on the body, palm, soften and just touch with your fingertips alone, your face, your head, your ears, your belly, yeah, the outsides of your hips and your thigh, the inside, the knees. Good. So what happens if we take those fingertips to the knees? Yep. And then a little vibration. Good. Tap the outside. It can be rhythmic or not. Doesn't matter. Tap the outsides of your thighs. Good. And the inside, gentle. The top. Good. Let's sit back a little further in our chair. A little more support underneath your seat. Nice. Lifting up through the right leg and foot, just crossing it over gently if this is comfortable. And if it's not, you can sit a little lower on your seat and cross only the ankle over the bottom of the leg. So there's always an option for you to be gentler. Nice. So once we get seated here, we want to make sure that left foot has a strong connection with the floor. Get nice and tall through the spine again, so that you're not tilting your body onto one side or the other, right? Really upright. And then lengthen through your spine again. Allow yourself to exhale as you shine the light on your heart, like it's a floodlight or a spotlight, shining forward. As you exhale, you're just hinging at your hips. Stay seated, stay connected, and allow your exhale to soften the lower back. So just as we did before, where we soften towards the center on our inhale, with our exhale, we see if there's a little more space there. So inhale, lengthen and soften. Exhale, allow yourself to go a little deeper into the stretch. Good. And then with this next exhale, we're gonna stay there for a breath, okay? So instead of moving back and forth, we'll stay. And allow yourself to soften the back of your neck. So your chin may drop just a bit. Good. Soften your shoulders and your jaw. You're ready, you can start to rise up by bringing the chin towards the chest and rolling the spine up to straight. Uncross your foot, little rumble in your heels. And then lifting up the left leg now, crossing it over. So get yourself situated again, nice and comfy in your seat. Long through your spine, hips are level, chest is level, nice. And your next exhale, allowing yourself to hinge. The seat stays really connected to the chair. Good. And maybe you find yourself hinging only an inch. Perfect. Right, but we want the spine to stay, and I'll turn sideways, relatively straight. What we don't want is to round the spine. Keep the spine straight. And we will come back to upright with a few inhales, exhale, a little deeper. And then when you feel like you've met your edge, your boundary as far as depth, then you can stay and take a couple of longer breaths there. Keep pressing your seat into the ground and your right foot into the ground. Chair is the ground that your seat is on. Yeah. Nice. And when you're ready, you can begin to roll the chin down towards the chest and round up as you roll the spine up. Good. Coming back up to vertical, both feet to the floor now. So taking palms out, inhaling as we lift and raise the arms up overhead. Exhaling, just touch the space, palms face down, lengthen through the arms. Yes, we'll do that a few more times. Inhale. And with your exhale, maybe you make a sound with your exhale and just allow yourself to sigh. And just know you're letting go of something that you don't need anymore. Good. One more. And then your palms come in to your heart space. Just be in that stillness for a moment. Breathing in and out and noticing your lung volume, right? So as you're noticing your lung volume, also notice your feet on the floor. Notice the character of your spine. So as you take an inhale in and an exhale, how would you define your lung volume now on that same scale of 1 to 10? Where 1 is very little and 10 is as much as you could fill your lungs with breath. And then there's this moment of thank you to the body. And a moment of gratitude for the space that holds us and for the community that holds us. Thanks, friend.
Thank you, Miss Emily.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you, Emily.
Everybody is on mute, so if you want to speak to Emily, you can unmute yourselves.
Yeah, please.
Very nice. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Nice. Yeah. Good exercise.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Good move. I'm so happy you're here. What's that?
Yetta?
I said all good movement. I don't exercise or movement.
Mm-hmm. I'm with you there.
You can call it whatever you want. I don't know. I don't really like to exercise. So
I don't die. Right?
I like to play.
But we're getting a lot of that, especially with flies.
Yes, yes. It's so good for your cells and for your nervous system. That agility training is like really, really exceptional for your nervous system. Yeah. And it feels silly, but it works.
I like silly.
Me too.
Jacqueline, we have you on mute. Do you want to unmute yourself so you can say hello? You don't know how?
So there's a little red microphone on your screen. Do you see that? If you click it, it might give you that option. I don't know, Steve. Do you have a better instruction?
down at the very bottom of the screen to the very left, it says mute. If it's got a red line, just click on that.
It's a little red microphone. Oh, I thought I heard her for a second.
There it is.
Oh,
there, it is.
There you go.
Yes. Yay.
Yay.
Jackie, we're so glad to have you with us. Who is the person behind you?
That was my husband.
And what is his name?
Steve. He's running away right now.
That's okay. That's okay. Well, we like everybody named Steve.
No,
that's right. Absolutely.
Yes, we do. Jackie, come back anytime. We are here 5 days a week.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's so nice to meet you, Jackie. I'm Emily.
Well, and it's a good program, Jackie.
Pardon?
It's a good program.
Yes, I understand that it is.
Yeah, every day is a little bit different.
Well, good. That's a good thing.
Keeps your brain running.
Right. And we're
that's what we need.
We're a community, Jackie, so you are now part of our community.
Well, good.
Yes.
Good. That sounds good.
Let's take a look at what's coming up tomorrow. Okay, today is Emily Corbin with Moving to Heal. Tomorrow is, how did it get to be Friday already? I don't know.
That's good.
I guess so. Melodic Memories with Piano and Violin. Jackie, this is brought to us every Friday by the Texas Winds, and we have a different musician or a group every Friday. So pop in.
Yeah, definitely. I like that.
Good, good. Some of them are sing-alongs and some of them are sit back and listen, or however it works for you.
Okay.
Yes.
I don't want to scare anybody, so I'll probably sit back and listen.
I tend to mute myself when I get to singing too loud.
We mute ourselves when it's music.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Yes. So we don't interrupt. That's right. So glad to have everybody with you. We had a very few faithful folks yesterday for the art with the Amon Carter Museum. Please, once it's posted on YouTube, go and take a look at it. We had information yesterday about buses. And you just don't know how interesting buses can be until you had Peggy to show you about the Amon Carter and buses.
That's true.
I'm sorry I missed it yesterday.
Mm-hmm. When it's posted, you need to go and take a look at it.
Some of these are not your grandfather's buses at all.
Yeah, I know.
Wow.
How about the drag race buses?
No, they're the abstract buses.
Okay.
The Flat Stanley bus.
Oh, Flat Stanley's. Yeah. Okay.
Yes. We had some pictures back to the early 1900s.
Oh, wow.
As well as some a bus stop, which was interesting, that was people.
Mm-hmm. Oh, wow.
Get yourself on YouTube in a day or two when it's posted and take a look. Does anybody have anything they want to share with the group today before we sign off?
Nope.
Okay. All right. Well, we'll see you tomorrow for the Texas Winds at 10:30. Be there or be square.
Thank you, Emily.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you, Emily.
Bye.